Hey, welcome back to Dark Cloud 2. I left off with going to the future, so let's do that real quick, and then I'll head back out and start killing shit again. Okay, so it seems like I'm going after a time turner of sorts. I don't think that the rules on this one make any sense, but a lot of the rules for these things don't make any fucking sense. If you tell me that it can only go back to a time that is significant to somebody, well then I can just say, oh, that time is significant to me. And it would truly be, because I want to go back in time to it. It therefore is now significant to me. So that's not really a good way of phrasing that. $300. $300 for something that can go back in time? That's stupid. But truthfully, any rule that you make up about time travel is gonna be stupid. Unless you do, like, a bunch of testing to make sure that everything you could possibly say was gonna be thought of. And that would take days and days and days of doing nothing but sitting there and saying, this is a thing, this is a thing, this is a thing. And I don't think that would work entirely. Time travel shit is always going to be ridiculous, because time travel really isn't possible. We can't go back in time. We go forward in time, we can't go back in time, because time is a sort of abstract concept that we apply to things, but it's not really a thing. That's not how it works. It was the first time travel movie that I watched as a kid was... You know, that's probably not true. The first time travel movie that I remember from when I was a kid was Terminator 2. Came out in 94 or 93. I think it was 94, though. And I watched it right around that time when I was a kid. And it was an interesting point that you could have somebody travel back in time to change future events. Then I started thinking about it, and I realized that if you go back in time in any sort of fiction, if you allow the characters to go back in time to change future events, come on, target the motherfucker, then you will never have gone back in time in the first place. So you can't do that. That's not possible. You'd create later on I learned that that's called a paradox and you can't do that. But as a kid, it bugged the shit out of me that anybody would be allowed to go back in time and then have it actually change events. You can't do that. In my mind, it didn't make sense. So, if it doesn't make any sense to do that, then there's got to be other ways that you could have time travel work, because it's fiction and people want to have their fucking fiction so that they can have fun time travel shit. Well, if you're going to try and do fun time travel shit, then you've got to have something else. Then we started thinking about M theory and string theory, and having the concept of multiple universes. Like, every single thing that ever happens all at once. It just creates multiple parallel realities where that decision was created. But that wasn't actual physics. Those are all thought experiments. None of those actually are anything. So, since none of those are actually anything at all, none of it actually works. And that bothered me even more. The concept of multiple universes doesn't really work for time travel, because that doesn't mean you're time traveling. That just means you're traveling to a different universe. You're not meeting your family ever again. They're all gone. Science fiction movies and TV shows just straight up make up things that will fix everything. I love the writing concept of a wizard did it. You don't have to actually think of anything yourself. Just make a wizard do it. In science fiction movies, it's the exact same thing. It's just not wizards all the time. 'Cause Jedi are space wizards. That's what they are. They're space knights, space samurai, however you want to see that. But they're also space wizards. Star Wars never really did a bunch of time travel stuff except for expanded universe stuff. Star Trek did it a lot. That was extremely fucking common for Star Trek. So much that they even did it in Picard and just kind of mirrored the fucking one of the original Star Trek, the original series movies. I liked that season. I thought it was fun, but you know, they did a lot of things with Star Trek Picard that I wasn't really much a fan of. You know what? I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to talk about a lot of the damn time in any video, but I think at some point in the near future I'm going to do a video where all I fucking do is talk about Star Trek Picard and Star Trek Lower Decks and is it the fucking Captain Pike one that's on right now. I like Star Trek and I never really get to talk about it with anybody, and no matter what, whoever's watching this is either a rapt audience or gonna leave, so they're gonna fucking leave because I talk about Star Trek. It's kind of one of the things that, like, build up who I am in the first place, so... Or it'd be ridiculous for you to stay, find out I like Star Trek, and leave. Because, that's who I am already. I guess, to be fair, anytime you find out fucking anything about somebody, it's a new opportunity to cut that person entirely out of your life. You don't have to sit and hang around with people just because you've invested time into them. And if you've invested time into a YouTube channel, that's definitely no reason to fucking stick around. You know, I've had this problem in the past, that I'm just so fucking bad at self-promotion. Promoting the channel is something that we ought to be trying to do. We ought to be trying to push that. But I'm not. Because to me, promoting the channel is promoting myself. And that just feels very awkward to me. Like, who am I to tell people that they ought to like me? What the hell? I got slightly closer and that tornado and that other dragon popped up. This fucking wizard... Oh, the shadow is... Okay, shadow actually says that it's a lot closer. It looked like it loaded in first and that it was further away than the dragon. It was slightly closer. God damn, man. There's a bunch of shit over in that corner. Also, the time travel in this game, I already said, doesn't make sense, but it makes even less sense, the concept that you'd move backward and forward in time, trying to change and find things that are at different points in time in order to fix those things, and that memories could exist outside of a thing when the whole concept of memories is purely electrical impulses within the brain that fit in to things you have done before. They're just patterns of things that you've built as memories. None of this could possibly work on that system. So their brains are not ours, and memories to them don't exist within our plane of existence. Otherwise, they would lose them and then never have them if a thing never existed in the first place. Okay, do I have a boss fight now? Where I have to fight a fucking assassin with Monica, who doesn't even seem to fucking... Yep, she's gonna lose pretty fucking quick. I think that might be the point, though. Because they can't expect me to fucking win this fight. Yeah, look at that fucking health bar. And then look how much I've got fucking taken off after one hit. She had nothing done to her. She won't target the motherfucker either.
That all you've got? How pathetic.
Is that Michael Douglas? Oh my god, they do expect me to actually fight that motherfucker. There's no chance of Monica winning that fight without a shitload of training, so that's not happening today. That's just not even really possible, I don't think. Nothing that she does is gonna do all that much damage. So I'm done for right now. I hope you enjoyed this episode, and I hope next episode I actually have something to do. I'll see y'all later. Bye.